You know, Google's making business owners absolutely scared of updating their Google Business profile. They're becoming petrified of being suspended. Imagine just trying to make one change to your business, like changing your address or telephone number, and suddenly you're waiting days after days. And you can see this as a common occurrence where people are just constantly finding they've got no business through Google because some part of their account has been called into question. Some get suspended for a few weeks, maybe 15 days or more. Worse still, you can even have 108 days, as you would have seen in one of my previous videos.
And it's now today, the 14th of November, and I'm making this video as you've just got it reinstated. That's 108 days.
Now, if you're not prepared to follow the guidelines, it's fair enough. Google has every right to say you've broken its policies and guidelines. And it's important to be familiar with where those guidelines are and what you need to do to follow them. But that isn't the case in this video today. I'm going to show you how just genuine updates could actually be a cause for people being panicky about their business. And if you want to know about those guidelines, and if things go wrong, there's also a form you can fill out. I'll put some links down below to just make sure you're covered there. But what's worse is Google's often the cause of some of these issues. They change your Google apps, Google Business app to Google Maps. They change the way services operate. You can't now put down an address. They then introduce hybrid services as well. And generally, there's just been confusion over the last few years, which I believe is one of the reasons why there's so many being suspended of genuine innocent businesses. And you would have seen that in that account of the 108 days it took for a genuine window cleaning business to be re-established again. But in this video, I'm going to try and change the way we think about things with Google. Now, I have a reason to change my business telephone number on my account. And rather than being panicky about making the change, I'm going to go ahead and make that change. I've changed my telephone provider, I have a new business number, and so there are several things that I'm going to need to do to make this work. So I'm going to jump on my computer now and show you how I do it, and hopefully we'll see what the results are, and I'll hopefully be without a suspension.
So if you click on these three dots, so you notice I've got my number here, and that's the one that I'm going to remove. So you click on the three dots, go to advanced settings, and you notice there's a new area here where you can now show or don't show your number. So phone number, whether you want it to show or not. And that's a choice now because many again get perhaps too many phone calls. So you may want to remove that. That may take some time to show. Let's just refresh it. So at the moment that's still showing, but in time that will then be removed. You notice we now get this card, add your number. So it recognizes that ideally it wants you to have your number. As I said, I'm going to be changing my number. So that's not the case. But if you click on that, just notice it takes you through to then adding your phone number. And now you notice the edit is being reviewed.
So there is a new way now you can just remove your number and it won't affect anything. So that's useful if you just find you're getting too many phone calls and you just don't want to have you want the privacy of your number and you want the privacy of address, you have now an option to remove those if you want. But will that actually affect the way in which we rank our business? Well, let's take a look.
So notice here on my business, I removed the number, but it now says add your phone number. So I'm just gonna show you then how that works. So if I go to add my phone number, I can put my new phone number in here. I'm just looking at customer interactions. Of course, your phone number gets logged as calls. So you can see how many calls you got, and you can then see also how that may be affected. So you may want to monitor that over time. Personally, when people contact me, I prefer them to email me. So you can see here, I've started to turn off the phone number, trying to encourage emails. If you want to know about it, it's adding your map to your website. I did a video on that recently, which is really helpful. So you may want to just check that out as well. I'll put a link down below for that. It's a really useful little trick that we did. So I'm now going to add my phone number, and I want this then to show because this will be my new number on my new contract. Okay, and you notice now it says pending, may take up to 10 minutes. You may want to be close to your phone in case Google actually gives you a call just to check it's a reputable number. And then you can just check out a few other bits as well to just understand what it is that that status means. So if I refresh that, you'll notice that at the moment it's now saying your edit is being reviewed. And you go to advanced settings again just to make sure that you've got your phone number turned on so it will show. So that's fine. If you click that, then it won't show. But if you want it to show, you just leave it as it is.
But the key thing is you want your number to be consistent everywhere you go. You need to make sure you check to see exactly where it can be found, because Google's also interested to see, is that a consistent number on your website? So you're going to need to update your website and your citations as well for this to actually then have any authority in Google.
So if I go to my website at the moment, you'll see my number shows my old number. And Google may well check my website to confirm my new number. So I need to update this. Now you can see my new number, but it's also worth consistently checking it's showing it everywhere. So there are other parts of the website need editing too. So you might need to go into widgets. So now I've done my website, I now need to just look at all my other citations. So I go to Yale to just get an idea.
So what Yale's particularly good at is just checking that the citations out there reflect the real world citations. And it just does it by exploring 20 or so of the most important ones. So I find this quite useful just to get an idea as to how many I've got to change. And it gives you links through as well to the accounts. Remember the NAP, name, address, phone number. So we do want to keep that consistency where we can.
So notice if I log into here and then I do a scan, and that's the number it's going to be looking for. And there you go, 100% now incorrect. So inconsistent. So, and of course we know what it is, it's the number. So I've changed my number. I just need to now go through all of these to make sure my number is correct. And again, I can check on places like Facebook and again, change that. And it's literally just a case of going into each one, logging in, making a change.
So it's fair to say that if you make one big change at a time and you recall exactly what you do, normally 10 minutes later Google then approves it, and you need to make sure it's consistent with the rest of your business. So that's something I'm going to be doing over the next few weeks, is just making sure that number is consistent across all various citations. And that will help me rank just slightly more in the coming weeks ahead as that consistency comes back through. There are many things small businesses can do right today, just takes a few minutes to help them rank even stronger than before. And I want you to now do that with your account by heading over to this video and following it, and you'll see some incredible increases in your ranking as you follow this process. I'll see you there.